Right, today I'm going to make a plaque, or make the model for the plaque, and then it'll be ready for moulding and then casting with concrete. I made one from clay a while back, but I wasn't happy with the edges inside, so I'm going to make a new one and make it from plaster of Paris, and when the plaster of Paris has gone hard, I'm going to sculpt the design into the plaster of Paris to create a sharper version of this. And this particular plaque is a star sign, and I think it's Sagittarius, so that's the design we're going to use. And right, so anyway, get started. I've cut up, these are just old, this is an old picture frame, but I cut it up to four pieces to make a square, which I'm going to screw to this old breadboard, and that'll create our shape, our square shape, which will create a tile, and it's about 6 inches square. So I'm going to screw this into the breadboard. I've screwed this down before, so the holes are still there. So you can make your pieces out of anything you like, a bit of wood or whatever. It just so happened that I had a bit of old frame hanging around the place. Okay, right, the base is screwed down, that's relatively tight. I'm going to seal the edges with some clay. I've got some old clay hanging around, so that's obviously to stop the plaster of Paris running out. I'm not going to do the inside, so there will be a little bit of seepage, and I'll just scrape those off once the plaster has gone hard. Alright, so here we go. I'm going to kind of roll these up into strips or whatever. I'm just going to put that around the edge. Like so. Right, so I've got a jug here with some water in, and now I'm going to add the plaster of Paris to the water. If I can open the bag up and then stir it in. Right, so the plaster of Paris, I think that's pretty well mixed up. And now I'm just going to pour it into the square base. I probably mixed up a little bit too much here, but I can use this on something else. Doesn't look too straight, so I'll prop that up with something. All Alright, so there we are. I've filled the plaster of Paris into the frame to create a plaque. And obviously wait for that to dry. I had to prop it up on the right hand side a little bit because it was not quite level. So perhaps before starting, make sure your surfaces are level. And there we are. I'll tap it a little bit to get the air bubbles out. We should be okay. Not really too worried about the spillage. Okay, I'll leave it like that. If there's any holes and stuff, I could fill them in anyway. But anyway, we've got the basic plaque there. So okay, so I'll leave that for about an hour and then we'll come back. Okay, so I've let this set for probably just over an hour. I'm just going to take the clay away and release the plaster slab from the frame. So obviously I'll unscrew the frame. So there we are, I've taken the frame away and we're left with the slab. Just going to run a knife around this edge just to tidy the edges up. Right, and now we're going to lift the slab from the board. On the top with a hammer, or I've just got a chisel there just to bang on the wood, and there we are. There's your slab. There's a little bit of texture from the wood there, which I quite like, so I'll probably use that. But I can sand it down if I don't like the effect. So just going to tidy the edges up with the knife on this side. So there we are. We're ready for the next stage now. I'll probably round off the corners just a little bit right at the end. Right, now we're going to put our design on the slab. I'm going to do a series of star sign plaques. I'm starting off with Sagittarius for some reason. So you download an image off the internet or draw one freehand. I've made this one. I've actually downloaded this from the internet and cut the design out from this piece of paper. It's relatively thick paper, and now we're ready to transfer that onto the plaque. So I'll measure that out. We'll make it relatively central, as central as you can possibly get in. And I'm going to use a pencil just to go over that template, and then we're ready to carve out the design. Right, so here it goes. So go carefully. It might be an idea to stick down your transfer, but I'm just going to go careful here and just etch in the pencil lines. Right, okay, so we've penciled in the design, and there we are, we're left with the etching onto the slab, and now we can just start carving in the design. So I'll just test to see what it's like. So it's relatively easy to carve there, as you can see. So it's basically just getting those edges out and getting the plaster out and taking your time to carve that out. Now I've got an assortment of different tools here. I haven't got the proper sculpting tools, so I'm going to have to improvise. it's like dentist tool, a screwdriver here, a knife. I've also got a handheld engraver, which may come in handy. But I'm just going to start sculpting out the design with this screwdriver, just to start off. Right, now I've got the basic shape carved out by hand with the screwdriver and other bits and pieces and a knife. I'm going to start using the electric engraver to speed the process up. And obviously just take the time and carve out the shape. I've also got this Dremel type tool, which will help you out with maybe a lot of donkey work. So you get the big bits out in the middle just to start you off, but go careful not to ruin your design. Right, that's what we have so far. So I've carved that out with the tools and the electric engraver, the screwdrivers, knives and bits and pieces. What I'm going to do is, because the plaster of Paris is still retaining some moisture, so I'm going to leave that overnight and let it dry off, and then I'm just going to tidy it up with a bit of sandpaper and maybe a few tools and polish it off, and then it's finished. Right, all we need, this has been left for about 24 hours, maybe a bit less, but a lot of the moisture's out, so it's just a matter of tidying up now. I've got these files, I don't think they're much good though, really, to be quite honest. So there we are, there's the finished plaque. And that's ready for latex moulding, and we can make some casts from that. So you can do any star sign you want. I'm going to go through the whole 12 star signs at some stage. And so there we are, that's all ready for moulding to latex, and I'll do that shortly. And then I'll show you a paint job. I'll just paint this one up. I won't go through the process because there's plenty of videos doing that, but I'll paint it up and then show you that in a moment. Alright, so there's the plaque painted up, so that's a possible option for paint choices. What I'll do is probably put some varnish over the top of that and let that cure, and then it's time for latexing. And then obviously you can cast up a lot of concrete plaques. Anyway, hope that was helpful. Hopefully that was helpful, and see you later. Thank you very much. Bye for now.